lot of people feel that multiple choice testing, even though it's used extensively in large classes and in other high stake situations such as GRE tests and SAT tests, that it's really not an effective tool for learning. It's just a way to assess what people already know. But in our lab, we had the question, well, is this really a problem, an intrinsic problem of multiple choice testing, or is it just that most multiple choice tests are not well written? What I mean by that is they are written such that you can answer them using only your recognition memory, looking for the answer that it seems familiar that you've seen before, rather than having to actually retrieve what you know, what you studied, in order to select from the alternatives what is the correct answer. When you make the incorrect alternatives competitive in that way, that is, they are plausible answers. All the alternatives are recognizable. They're all things you've read about in your study. They could all be a plausible answer to this question. So not only do you have to you can't depend on recognition. You have to think about, are ones of, for example, not only why A might be correct, but why B and C and D are wrong. In the process of doing that, you retrieve information about B, C, and D, and then that information gets strengthened. So later, if you're asked a different question to which B, C, and D is now the correct answer, you'll be able to answer it correctly more often. To give you an example, suppose you've just read a lesson about the solar system, and now you're being asked about your reading in the form of multiple choice tests. And let's say the question is, what outer planet was discovered first by mathematical prediction rather than visual prediction? Well, the answer to this is Neptune. But let's say that the alternatives that you're given to pick among is Neptune, Uranus, and Saturn. Those are all outer planets that you've just read about. You have to think of something. If you're trying to decide which one of these outer planets was discovered by mathematical calculations rather than by visual sighting, you'll have to think about, why isn't it Saturn? Why isn't it Uranus in trying to select the correct answer, Neptune? So not only do you think about what do I know about Neptune, you are also thinking what do I know about Uranus and Saturn. On the other hand, what if the question was the same, but now the alternatives were Neptune, the correct answer, Mars, and Venus? You would immediately know from your just having read this passage about the solar system that neither Mars nor Venus is an outer planet. And so you don't even have to consider anything else you know about Mars and Venus. You can just reject them and pick Neptune. So we've done now considerable research showing that when you write multiple choice questions with what I'm calling competitive alternatives, competitive incorrect alternatives, those are ones that can't just be dismissed with recognition or familiarity. You have to retrieve, why is this not the correct answer? And when you have to do that, then you actually are learning not only the correct answer, but you're reinforcing the information that you already know about those incorrect alternatives. Then on the final exam, teachers don't usually ask you the very same question that they asked you on a practice exam. So now in the final exam, let's suppose a question does come up about Uranus or about Saturn. You're going to be better able to answer that because they appeared as incorrect alternatives on a previous practice multiple choice test than you would have otherwise. And we've actually done the research in the lab that shows this to be true. So in fact, multiple choice testing, if correctly done, that is, if it's written in a way to have competitive incorrect alternatives, has both the ability to improve your memory for the correct answer. It also improves your memory and ability to ask questions about related information, that is, information related to those incorrect alternatives. So in a way, it's a completely win-win situation. But it does require that the multiple choice tests be written correctly. And this is where I think we as instructors need to do a better job. We need to take the time. It's easy to write poor multiple choice questions. It's difficult to write ones that will result in this sort of learning that I'm talking about, where the incorrect alternatives are competitive, they are plausible, there are reasons that they could be the right answer, and you have to come up with how can I reject this as the correct answer.